Hey guys, what's up? It is I, Trevor J. Haven't made a video in so long, and I apologize for that. I really fucking do. A lot has been happening since then. My first video, honestly, I'm not even proud of it, so let's not even talk about it. Bitch, over. I'm kind of in a rush today, so what we're going to do is we're going to, do a basic face. Well, what I mean by basic face is just, do a face. So yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and just get started because it's been a while. Might I start off by saying that most, if not all, the products I'll be using today are, if you guys know me, you guys already know, Fenty. Fenty as fuck. I love Fenty. Like, Fenty is life. Rihanna totally did her thing. And yeah, I'm obsessed. I've been obsessed since she came out. So I started off with these two, the Pro Filter. No, actually, just yeah, the Pro Filter, both the primer and the shadow. I mean, foundation, in shade 300. However, I don't live in Florida no more, so I'm not that dark. So when she came out with the mattifying, I totally caught those for sure. Mattifying. Pro Filter Soft Matte. Yep. And now I'm shade 255 because I'm not as tan as I used to be. So yeah, let's just get started because, bitch, I'm late. First of all, let me tell you that. So I do mix my primers. I'm gonna start off with Baby Skin Primer from Maybelline, New York. So I start off with that just to like really get to my pores. And I am filming on the floor currently. Because I have not yet set myself up for success in the abode. So yeah. Anyway, so yeah. Primer important? I think yes, definitely. So unfortunately, I used to mix these two, as you can tell, because this bitch is like subtly totally ran out. So yeah, now I just, yeah, just use this one alone, but it's okay. The purpose is still the same. It's not better. I really like this one because it's like, mattifying as fuck. Yes, I do have redness in the skin, or on the face, I should say. So, yeah. I totally failed myself by not doing this in front of the mirror. But it's okay because I also got the Fenty Beauty Galaxy palette, which comes with a built-in mirror. So, I'll just look at that. Okay, period. Well, anyway, yeah, let's get started because, as I said, I am in a rush. And I don't want to be here later than I already am. So, yes, as I mentioned, I am now going to use the Fenty Beauty in shade 255 Pro Filter, of course. Let's go ahead and go in with the foundation brush. I recently bought, like, I have the sponge, of course, because I'm a bad bitch. So, I do have the sponge. Bitch, where did you go? Where did you go? Oh, here we are. The sponge, I use it so much, it's not white anymore. And like, I need to clean it. I just cleaned it like last week, but bitch, just how much I use it. But I'm gonna go in with my foundation with the full body foundation brush. I think I sort of like mastered painting my face like pretty quickly, like because I was watching my first video that I did. I don't really do tutorials per se, I just do my makeup, so it's like a get ready with me, you feel me? I don't know why I was like tutorial, bitch, no, more like a get ready with me, period. I'm gonna get under the nose before I forget. I love getting like a foundation everywhere on my face. Like, I just don't like looking like I missed spots. So I like get as deep as I can to the hairline everywhere. I mean, everywhere. Bitch, yes. You gonna see me dabbing all over the place. So I know you guys are like, bitch, you only used one squirt. Well, duh. I kind of like learned my lesson because my first video, I was just using like a bunch of fucking pumps. And I was like, bitch, no, I don't want cake face. And so, yeah. So I just, now I just do it pump by pump. Whatever the pump doesn't, if the one pump doesn't suffice, of course I go in again for some more product. So yeah. I try to use as less as possible because you know, we all want to avoid cake face if we can. Besides, they say use 3 pumps. So, yeah. I think that they know what the fuck they're talking about because I usually end up using like 3.5 or something like that. Y'all don't do y'all ears. Let me tell y'all something. Y'all crazy as fuck. Like, why do you want to walk around with like red as fuck ears or ears that just don't match the tone of your foundation? You're gonna be looking, especially for me, like I have an industrial bar, so I love to like show it off. So yeah, it's important for me to like definitely get my ears and my neck. I mean, everyone gets their neck, you know. There's some people that just don't do it. We want to look as covered as possible, period. You see, I am now on my 3rd pump. Since I'm showing a little bit of chest, let's get that. So there's a lot that has been going on with me lately, and I am totally going to share as I continue making videos. So yeah, you guys better stay tuned and get ready because it's about to be a whirlwind with me, because like I'm about to share so much of my life, and yeah, things are going to start rolling, you feel me? Because yeah, it's been such a long time. I've been battling with identity issues. I've been going to counseling and things like that. So, you know, I've finally reached like a really comfortable spot in my life where I'm like recommitting to like so much, be it my job, be it like, I am in recovery, by the way, shall I say, start off saying that right now. And what that means to me is that I am in recovery for, you know, not, well, drugs are drugs. Anything that's mind-altering, bitch, it's a drug. So I am in recovery, and I think it's important that I share that with people because, you know, people would look at me and they'll, like, never know. Like, I used to have a, I was in, like, a very toxic relationship for about 5 years, and that led me to become chemically dependent on cocaine. Yes, I was introduced to cocaine while I was in that relationship. But cocaine was never really my drug of choice. It's just something that happened and that really hooked on me. So that happened. And then also, I was like a big stoner. Like, there was not one day, not one second that I was not stoned out of my mind. So yeah. I am in recovery, and so yeah, that's why I go to counseling. I am in like a program currently. I tried quitting by myself and it didn't work out, so I was like, you know what, when I was offered a program to help me, I was like, yes, let me go forth with this full body. I kind of sort of begged for the program too, if I'm honest. If you guys are wondering like, what program? Okay guys, well, it's no secret, I'm a bad bitch, period. So, I am in a program called Drug Court. I do live in the state of Georgia. It is in one of the counties. I'm not going to disclose which county just because. But yeah, I do live in Georgia currently, and I am in drug court in one of their many counties. So yeah, I am in phase two, so close to the end of phase two. I have been having trouble lately. Drug court, they have sanctions, you have to abide by rules, et cetera, et cetera. So I've been, doing the best I can. I recently had to move from like a family member's house because things just weren't working out. I'm not gonna bash anyone because, my family, they helped me while they, could. And I guess like things just weren't working out, so I had to move. And yeah, so that along with all my freaking personal issues, like identity issues, trauma, that just was like, a very hot mess. And like, I was doing a little bit terrible in the program, but now I'm back and I'm better than ever. And yeah, I'm just focusing on my recovery and on myself. So, yes. Yes. So I just wanted to say that because I've been like, yesterday marked a full year that I've been sober from cannabis. I'm not gonna say I've been sober for a full year because unfortunately I haven't been. I did have a lapse in my recovery. And let me just say this, there is a difference between lapse and relapse. When you lapse, it is when you like, it doesn't cut the fact that you used. A lapse is like when you, unfortunately, you use and then you learn from it. A relapse is when you use and you don't stop for a minute. Like you go back and you have to restart from square one. I mean, you could restart from square one if you have a lapse in your recovery, but it's all on how you look at it. You don't necessarily have to. But yeah. So I had a lapse in my recovery with MDMA, Molly, or ecstasy. I honestly don't know which one it was, but it was a feel-good pill. And I don't do pills. So of course I had to like mix it in some orange juice and just swallow it. But yeah. I'm traumatized from a past relationship. I don't do pills anymore. I can't even take like I was prescribed a Z-pack like a few weeks ago, and I couldn't even take it because I did not want to take any pills. But yeah, okay, come through concealer. But yeah, as I said, I learned from my lapse, and I, had to recommit. So I've been sober for a year from cannabis, but not sober for a year entirely. So yeah. It was a little bit upsetting because I was at my 9 month. It was 9 months sober, like completely sober, 9 months completely sober, but I ruined it because I used. So yeah, I've been sober from cocaine for, it'll be a year in March. I'm not gonna count all of yours. So moving on from that, yes, I am in recovery and I wanted to let you guys know because I'm an open book. Let me show you guys my contour stick from Fenty Beauty, my Fenty Beauty contour stick. Look, bitch, it's all gone. That's how much I use this contour stick because I love it. Like, yes, period. Now, I know you guys used to see me like contour like crazy, contour my face like crazy. I don't do that anymore. I mean, I do if I'm feeling like a little bit fat or whatever. And because me personally, I'm not used to like being a little extra heavy. But I do love how my body looks when I gain a few pounds. But it's just not comfortable for me. And I just hate how it shows in my face, So yeah, and unfortunately, like as much as I try to keep on the extra weight, I can't. Like it always like disappears. Like I gain it and then I end up doing something that like causes it to go away. And I'm like, damn it, I couldn't even keep it in my thighs or nothing. Like, ugh. So, yeah. Contour is like a lifesaver because you could do so much with contour. It's amazing. So, guys, let me tell y'all something. If you're going to contour your jawline, bitch, look. Make sure you raise your face and do it under. Don't do it over. Because you want to look like, you want to have it look like a shadow. You don't want to have it over. You feel me? Like, do it under. Not over. Period. Yes. And I know some people are like, well, bitch, like, who's going to look under there? Look, no one has to look under there, okay? Like, it's just, you know, trust me, the light is funny. Like, lighting is funny. Like, you will notice. Like, once you do it, you will notice. People might not notice, but girl, you will. You will. And that's all that matters. Trust me. Besides, people contour any and everything. People contour abs on themselves. Like, who does that? Like, girl, if you don't take your ass to the gym like everybody else, if you don't do sit-ups at the crib like everybody else, like, people be funny. People be so funny. Period. Okay. So I did mention to you guys my identity issues. Y'all are just gonna, like, have to wait till the video comes. But yes, something I've been struggling with for, like, a long time. Struggling to be okay with. I've been in denial for so many years. And I'm just fucking tired of it, you feel me? Like, I need to be me, the best me that I know how to be. And so, yeah, like, I finally made the decision. I closed everyone out for, like, a while on this. Like, everyone was like, what the fuck? I went to, you know, I had to go and talk to myself for a minute, get in tune with nature, and, you know, yeah. I had to make sure that everything was because I wanted it that way, you feel me? Because I wanted to do it for me, not for anyone else. Yeah, so I definitely had to take charge of my own life, and I did. You know? I did. Okay, contour. Yes. My contour spread it out like blush, but that's okay. That's okay. Face is pretty much done. Contour done. Yes. I'm so late. Like, they're gonna hate me. So, anyway, I just contoured. So, concealed already. So, what's next on the list? Okay, so. Do I want a bronze? No, because you already. Bitch, did you just. I hate when my nails do that. I just fucked up. Like, yes. I do. I'm a big fan of the minis because, bitch, I love. Great highlighting on the go. You feel me? And sometimes, like the big one, like, I love it. But girl, if you could get a fucking deal, why not go with it? You feel me? Like, girl, like, they give you a fucking gloss palm. They're giving you a fucking lip gloss. Poppin'. Lip gloss. And a highlighter. Like, why not take advantage of that? A little more shine, bitch. have some in here. Okay. So now, why do I keep closing my freaking mirror? Like, girl. Now time to do my eyebrows. Yes. So let me tell y'all something. For my eyebrows. Well, bitch, first let me do some eyeliner before I don't do that. So funny story, my eyebrows, I actually do them. I use a concealer. I use a concealer to do my eyebrows. Like, yes. When I first started doing makeup, my friends just gave me so many of their things. Yes, my friends gave me so many other things. And yeah. I took it upon myself to learn techniques. My foot just fell asleep. That's the downside of like being on the floor. But it's okay, because bitch, I'm flexible. But of course, my man already knows that. But anywho, yes. I use a concealer from Black Opal. It's a total coverage concealing foundation. I don't know if you guys can see that, but I just put it all over your face. And yeah, I use this as a freaking pomade for my eyebrows because why not, bitch? Why not? I don't want no clumps. Period. Okay. I don't really do my eyebrows like many people do. Like, I like my eyebrows looking as full as possible with that little slight ombre-ish thing. So kind of like this, I'm okay with my eyebrows like this right now. Like I literally just do the tail. So I could have that little fade at the beginning. And I have to fill in this eyebrow. Usually I just like, you know, do a little slit. But no, like I don't have those materials with me. So I'm gonna have to like fill this in completely. I just fucked up the shape of my brow. No. Oh, goodness, now I'm gonna make it a little thicker. Fuck. Yeah, this eyebrow usually makes me change my fucking mind about my little ombre-esque feeling because I just messed it up. I don't know how it looks on camera, but you know what? Let's just do a little texture. Right eyebrows, you got me. Whatever. If I mess it up, I'll clean it up off camera because I ain't got time to waste my time right now. But yeah, there goes my face. Worse than blush. Okay, so for a long time, I have the shade Trippin' that came with the matchsticks. It looks like this. I never knew what to do with it. Allegedly, you could use it as eyeshadow, as lip. Let's see. Lip. Sorry, no. Nothing. But apparently, you could use it as blush, but like, I don't know. Like, I just don't know. Like, I see Priscilla Ono use it all the time, and I'm just like, girl. Anyway, so for blush, like, you know, many people do it very differently. I do it differently, of course, because yeah, I'm my own person, bitch. So I go under, like, pretty much under the contour line, like, right here. I start off right here. Bring the cheek brush to an angle. bring it a little bit up to meet with the highlighter. And then dabble a little right there. I have a friend and she like blushes a few areas of her face, and I'm just like, girl, I ain't trying to be red, period. But anywho, you guys, yeah, I'm as ready as I'm gonna get right now. And like I said, I'm late anyway, so yeah. I do also have some Fenty Beauty setting powder in the shade Butter. Should I set my face right now? I mean, I could. But do I want to? No, because I already freaking highlighted and blushed. Fuck. I mean, I still could, but no. Not today, honey. Where is my gloss bomb? Period. In my car. Good. Oh no, here it is. Here's the Fenty Glow gloss balm. And bitch, let me tell you, like, this is my favorite. Like, I ran out of it. Bitch, I didn't even highlight my Cupid's bow. Bitch, I see you. I'll probably do some wing liner. You know what? I might as well do wing liner while I'm on camera. Why not? While you're at it, bitch, how about we highlight the Cupid's bow? You know what? Why not? Okay. You totally left your freaking... Ugh. I left my freaking smudge. You know what? I'll just use this one. I like to highlight my eyebrows too. Right under the brow bone or whatever. Oh, bitch, you didn't even highlight. Yes. I don't like to highlight too much the nose area. But I do highlight this. No, because anything that the light really captures, that's what I will highlight. So, yeah, I also have, like, yeah, the Sunstalker thingy. Like, they come in minis. Girl, look, two highlighters. One of her bronzers. Like, I'm obsessed with Fenty. Like, I have the eye primer, the brush, some brushes, not all of them brushes. I have the sponge, like, bitch, I have. I'm a Fenty freak, period. So, yeah, now let's do our, you know what, let me use the big mirror, because shit, don't know. This video probably is gonna be as long as I thought it was gonna be. I'm not good at closing my eyes when I do my liner, y'all. I'm really not. And like my thing is, I try to do it as thin as possible. Like, I'm not a fan of thick liner. Like, I know some of y'all are, but not I. I'd be looking at thick liner and I'm like, girl. We're like, girl, why? Bitch, you're in a rush. You ain't got time to be perfect right now. I don't know why I'm doing winged liner if I'm gonna come home and do like a look. Oh, well, that just means you're gonna have to do a cut crease. Period. By the way, guys, I love doing cut creases. They are my thing. Bitch. I lifted that one too much. Did I? Well, I'm okay. But yes, I love doing cut creases. They are my thing. Oh. Sorry, I try to concentrate as much as possible when it comes to this. Because I'm a little OCD. Anyway, so yeah, that is, you know, my face. Like, my face right now. Yeah. This is my face. And I live. So I dress with the world. So, without further ado, that is it. That is all. I'll come home later and I'll do a cut crease since I already did my winged liner. So, yeah, let's get on with the show of life. Period. So, thank you for joining me. I'm going to try to upload as much as possible. I am going to take you guys on a life journey with me and start vlogging about it because, bitch, I am not an open book. I'm recommitting myself to a lot of things in my life. And yeah, I'm gonna take you guys on a journey with me. So, hashtag shop on iPhone, period.